Hello, and welcome to another Economics Homework Help video. This video looks at locating the equilibrium price and quantity on a supply and demand schedule. Before looking at a typical problem statement, let's look at the concepts of demand, supply, and equilibrium in a supply and demand model. The demand for a good represents the amount of a good that an individual is willing and able to purchase at different prices. Demand for a good may be represented as a schedule or a table of prices and their associated quantities. For example, a demand schedule for cups of coffee might look something like this. Notice, as the price of a cup of coffee increases, the quantity of cups of coffee demanded decreases. So individuals demand less of a good when its price increases, so that the price and the quantity have an inverse relationship. The supply of a good represents the amount of a good that firms are willing and able to supply at different prices. The supply of a good may be represented as a schedule or a table of prices and their associated quantities. For example, a table representing the supply of cups of coffee might look something like this. Notice that as the price of a cup of coffee increases, the quantity supplied increases as well. So, as the price increases, firms are willing and able to supply more of the good. So the relationship between price and quantity is a direct relationship. The term equilibrium means that a system is in balance. There's no tendency for the system to change. In the terms of the supply and demand model, this means what consumers are willing to pay for a given amount of good is the same as what firms are willing to supply and accept payment for. Let's take a minute to look in some detail at an example, why the equilibrium point is where the quantity demanded and the quantity supplied are equal. If the price the firm is willing to accept for a cup of coffee is $3, it will supply 3 cups of coffee. However, if a cup of coffee is $3, consumers are willing to purchase 5 cups. At a price of $3 per cup of coffee, the quantity supplied, 3 cups of coffee, is less than the quantity demanded of 5 cups of coffee. Since the amount of coffee supplied by the firm is less than it's demanded by consumers, the quantities are not equal. Therefore, the market is not in equilibrium. If the price the firm is willing to accept for a cup of coffee is $6, it will supply 6 cups of coffee. However, if the price of a cup of coffee is $6, consumers are only willing to purchase 2 cups of coffee. So, at a price of $6 per cup of coffee, the quantity supplied, 6 cups of coffee, is greater than what is demanded of 2 cups of coffee. Since the amount of coffee supplied by the firms is greater than what is demanded by consumers, the quantities are not equal, and therefore the market is not in equilibrium. Finally, if the price the firm is willing to accept for a cup of coffee is $4 per cup, it will supply 4 cups of coffee. If a cup of coffee is $4 per cup, consumers are willing to purchase 4 cups of coffee. At a price of $4 per cup, the quantity supplied, 4 cups of coffee, is equal to the quantity demanded of 4 cups of coffee. Since the amount of coffee supplied by firms is equal to the amount of coffee demanded by consumers, the quantities are equal. Therefore, the market is in equilibrium. Now, let's look at an example of a problem statement which asks us to locate the equilibrium price and the equilibrium quantity of a good. An example of a problem statement is, on the supply and demand schedule for tablet computers below, locate the equilibrium price and quantity. The strategy for finding the equilibrium price and quantity on a supply and demand schedule is 1. Compare the quantity supplied with the quantity demanded at either the first row of the table or the last row of the table. If the quantity supplied and the quantity demanded are unequal, move to the next row. 2. Repeat the first step until the quantity supplied is the same as the quantity demanded. 3. When the quantity supplied and the quantity demanded are equal, then read across to the price column for the equilibrium price. Next, let's apply the strategy to the problem statement. Now, let's use the strategy to find the equilibrium price and quantity on the demand schedule for tablet computers. Let's start looking for the equilibrium point, starting with the first row of the table. The lowest price in the table is $10 per tablet. At a price of $10 per tablet, the quantity supplied is 1 tablet and the quantity demanded is 7 tablets. So the quantity supplied and the quantity demanded are not equal because the quantity supplied one tablet is less than the quantity demanded of seven tablets. Let's move down to the next price of $20 per tablet. At the price of $20 per tablet, the quantity supplied is two tablets and the quantity demanded is six. So the quantity supplied and the quantity demanded are not equal because the quantity supplied two tablets is less than the quantity demanded of six tablets. Let's move down a row to the price of $30 per tablet. At a price of $30 per tablet, the quantity supplied is three tablets and the quantity demanded is five tablets. So the quantity supplied and the quantity demanded are not equal because the quantity supplied, three tablets, is less than the quantity demanded of five tablets. Next, move down a row to the price of $40 per tablet. At a price of $40 per tablet, the quantity supplied is four tablets and the quantity demanded is four tablets. So the quantity supplied and the quantity demanded are equal because the quantity supplied, four tablets, is equal to the quantity demanded of four tablets. So the equilibrium quantity for the market is four tablets. Next, to find the equilibrium price, read the price column where the quantity demanded is equal to the quantity supplied. The price where the quantity supplied and the quantity demand are equal is $40. So the equilibrium price is $40. So the answer to the problem statement is that the equilibrium quantity for the tablet market is four tablet computers, and the equilibrium price is $40 per tablet. This video looked at locating the equilibrium price and quantity on a supply and demand schedule. The video reviewed the concepts of supply and demand. It also reviewed the criteria for market equilibrium, that is, the price where the quantity supplied and the quantity demanded are equal. Next, the video reviewed a typical problem statement for finding equilibrium price and quantity in a supply-demand schedule. The video provided a strategy for finding the equilibrium quantity price by comparing the quantity demanded with the quantity supplied at each price. Once the point where the quantity supplied and the quantity demand was found, it was easy to read off the equilibrium price from the price column of the table. Finally, the video demonstrated how to use the strategy to find the equilibrium price and quantity on a supply and demand schedule. As always, if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please put them in the comment section below. Also, if you have ideas for a homework help video, please put them in the comment section as well. Until the next video, good luck with your economic studies.